So you want to start living a healthier lifestyle in 2020, do ya?
Well then you came to the right place, girl!
What's up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. So, guys, it's a new freaking year, but not only that, it's a new decade. Even more special. So there's no better time than to start working in health and fitness into your life, if you're not already. So I've come up with 10 very, very simple, easy ways to get healthier and more fit this decade. This is our decade, baby, yes. So guys, let's just get right into it. But first, if you're not already, please do subscribe for new videos every single week. You won't be sorry. Okay guys, so here are tips that I've come up with in no particular order, except for this number one, and that is to make yourself your top priority. Easier said than done, right? When you got other obligations, other people in your life that you're putting a lot of care into, I get it. But here's the thing. In order to focus on your health and your overall fitness, you absolutely have to make yourself top tier here. You can't take care of other people if you're not taking care of yourself. You should always be number one in that aspect. Once you make yourself a priority, everything else that I'm about to talk to you about in this video will become that much more easy. There's nothing wrong with making yourself a top priority. A lot of people get this twisted and think it's being selfish and that it's wrong to put yourself first, but that's not true, okay? It's not selfish. Creating more of a healthy lifestyle for yourself will better impact every single aspect around you in your everyday life. I'm talking relationships, I'm talking overall general happiness, your aura will be different, everything will change once you make yourself top priority, okay? Okay, so number two, I'm not going to go necessarily into saying something generic like you should incorporate exercise. That's a given if you want to get fit and healthy. But I know, and especially for beginners, that gymtimidation is absolutely 100% a thing. So I would never force you to like go to a gym or say, sign up for a gym membership, get your bum to a gym. In this sense, we want to take things slow and steady and do things in a healthy manner. I want you to be able to have these things stick for you. So, incorporating exercises at home is a really, really great opportunity for you to get the exercise you need in without feeling like totally intimidated, without feeling like you have to devote time aside, especially for those who maybe don't live near a gym. You are not helpless, you're not alone. I've actually been incorporating a ton of at-home workouts on my Instagram page, so definitely check that out. So for people who really can't leave the house, maybe you have children, you have other obligations, you can still get a quick workout in because any workout is better than no workout. And the beautiful thing is, you can own virtually no equipment. You can get small dumbbells at Walmart, any store, and you can literally do an entire full body workout with just dumbbells. If you can find a spot in your house, your little nook, that you can get your workouts done, only a little bit a day, is just a step closer to being a healthier you. I also did a YouTube video on a full body workout with only dumbbells. I'll have that link down below. Give that a try. So tip number three is to use social media to your advantage. We live in a time where social media is at an all-time high. And what comes with that? Loads and loads and loads of content. You would be surprised at how much you can learn from social media. You can find ideas, inspiration, motivation, things like that. Follow certain accounts that have like-minded individuals with like-minded goals, and it can help you centralize and work on yourself that way. Saving workouts on Instagram is a big one, okay? This way you're not lost as to like, okay, what do I do now? Sometimes you can overwhelm yourself and not think properly when it comes time to work out at the gym. You're kind of like, I don't know what to do. It's not healthy to just kind of wander around. You end up getting bored. You end up feeling like you don't know what you're doing. And that ultimately might lead to gymtimidation, which we're trying to avoid. So definitely use social media to your advantage. There's a whole world out there full of people just like you, rooting for you. I'm rooting for you. Not only for workouts, guys, they also have a ton of healthy recipes that you can find. Social media is where it's at. So tip number four is to hydrate yourself, baby girl. You may not realize it, but 9 out of 10 people, they're dehydrated. Actually, I'm pretty dehydrated right now, I guarantee it. Even when you don't feel dehydrated, there's a good chance that you are. You should be drinking approximately your body weight in ounces per day. So I'm 120 pounds, I should be drinking at least 120 fluid ounces per day. This is something that goes very unnoticed throughout the day when you're busy with other things. If you don't feel physically thirsty, you don't really actually think to drink. That's normal. Here's a tip. Always get yourself a decent sized water bottle. Go out to the store right now if you don't have one, okay? Not ones with missing lids, okay? Throw all that out and get yourself a brand spanking new water bottle, your prized possession. You will become best friends with this baby right here. This is my BFF. If it's in your face, you'll remember to drink it. That's just how the human mind works. Tip number five is to incorporate greens throughout the day, all right? So this is diet focused. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you to just go eat a bunch of vegetables, okay? Not many people really wanna do that. I don't even wanna do that. But what helps is to kind of incorporate little bits throughout the day in each of your meals, little snacks. So for example, sprinkling them in. If you make eggs in the morning, throw a few pieces of spinach in there, but you can definitely incorporate the micronutrients. It's overall just gonna help you feel more energized, put you in a better mood, it'll add up. Okay, so tip number six is to find yourself some healthy alternatives to eat for your favorite types of foods and to eat in, okay? So restaurants, try to cut down on, try to maybe even eliminate for the most part. James and I have officially cut restaurants out of our life. I know it's nice to like go out, dine out, things like that. And every once in a while, sure, treat yourself, for sure. But a lot of people don't realize that even when you think you're eating healthy at a restaurant, for example, a grilled chicken salad, supposed to be healthy, even if you get the dressing on the side, yeah, I'm gonna say that too, even if you get the dressing on the side, the bottom line is you do not know how that food is prepared and where it's sourced from. For example, that grilled chicken salad could easily be chicken that is injected with hormones, loads of sodium to help preserve it. So you might be thinking, yes, nice, healthy, fresh grilled chicken breast. I don't know about that. Restaurants are notorious for being jam-packed with sodium. Sodium's gonna keep that water retention up on you, baby, and you're not gonna like that. So cooking in is a great idea. Always planning your meals ahead of time. So for me, I like to just plan out the whole week, okay? Every day I know what I'm eating, go to the grocery store, grab all the stuff, meal prep what I can. So keeping it one step ahead like that and pre-planning your meals will help you to eat better without that feeling of, oh my God, I'm hungry, what can I eat? Let's just go out to eat. Desperate times, okay? You don't wanna reach the level of being desperate, because that will lead to fast food and just going and eating out. And let's not forget that it's very, very expensive to keep eating out. Finding healthy alternatives as well is a big one. You don't have to cut out cold turkey your favorite foods. If there's a food out there that you love, there's always a healthier version that you can find. Trust me. Wean off, baby. Just kind of wean down. You don't have to say, oh, well, I love ice cream, so I just gotta go cold turkey. I can't eat ice cream anymore. That ain't true, and you don't want to do that, because if you love it that much and you cut it out cold turkey, that's not healthy. You're gonna binge. You're gonna fall off and say, forget about it. I love my ice cream. There's healthier versions of ice cream out there. Believe me, healthy version for everything. I'm actually gonna be filming my favorite healthy alternatives video soon, so stay tuned for that, okay? That's coming up. Okay guys, so tip number seven is to make healthy foods super accessible to you. So kind of branching off of the last tip to try to pre-plan your meals and not eat out as much, what you wanna do to kind of work hand in hand is to make healthy foods super accessible so that that's what you're grabbing. Not only do you want that to be the first thing in the fridge or your cabinet that you see, healthy foods, but you want to make them grab and goes for when you get hangry. When that hunger creeps up on you and you're all of a sudden like, oh my God, I gotta eat something. I don't know, is that just me that happens too? Well, that happens a lot. So a trick I like to do is when I go grocery shopping and I'm buying things like celery, carrots, cucumbers, salad, like romaine lettuce, the second I get home, I wash all my vegetables, I chop them up, okay? Shave off whatever you gotta do. Prep your veggies and store them away right in front of your face in that fridge, girl. Make the unhealthier foods, shove them in the back. Make them out of reach. Make them super inconvenient to get to. In the pantry, store those yodels, those chocolatey deliciousness, those Doritos, take them and just chuck them as far back into the back as you can, all right? Trust me, out of reach, you ain't gonna wanna bother with that. So, little trick is to just make healthy foods and snacks super convenient. Tip number 8, big one, actually super big, is to adopt and practice self-discipline. Put it this way, guys, the body will not go where the mind does not allow it to go. In other words, you really need to change your whole perspective on healthy living in general. This change is not a punishment. This is a wonderful, beautiful change. You need to embrace it. It's all in here, baby. I just created a how to adopt self-discipline video. Check it out, I'll have it linked down below. A self-disciplined mindset is what's going to get you going further than temporary motivation, okay? Motivation is just a very temporary fix. Might get you through the day, but your mindset, okay? Your self-discipline is what's going to get you to completely change your lifestyle and not just be healthier in 2020, but be healthier for the whole next decade. So, it's mindset's everything. Okay, so tip number 9 is to decrease the amount of alcohol intake. I know it can get cray. On the weekends, you wanna go out, have fun, this, that, and the other thing, but you would be surprised how just kind of stepping back from alcohol a little bit could change your whole world. It will help you perform better at the gym. It will help you think clearly. And let's not forget that alcohol dehydrates you like no other, okay, girl? So if you're trying to keep hydrated, maximum energy, complexion looking dope, yeah, gotta reconsider that alcohol. Mm-hmm. Okay, guys, last tip of the day. This has helped me significantly, believe it, is to grab a partner, yes. So you're starting this new healthy life, you're starting fresh. Why not do it with somebody who has a like-minded mentality, someone that you can explore and have fun with and kind of enjoy the journey with. Having a partner really, it really helps you to kind of stay accountable. You have that other person with you at all times. They know your goals, you know theirs. You guys can motivate each other and it just keeps you a little more in line, okay? At least for me, it definitely does. So for example, my partner, it's my fiance, James. So James and I are really big on this, the health, the fitness type of lifestyle. And we really depend on each other some days. I'm not gonna lie, there's a lot of times where I get in a rut, it's normal, and I don't feel like working out. I don't wanna go to the gym. And that's when I have him to kind of just shake me up a little bit and say, look, we're doing this. And it gets me out that freaking door. So never feel like you're too proud to have somebody to kind of help you get through this, especially if it's new to you. It really does help, okay? If you wanna join a gym but you're a little bit nervous, grab a friend, okay? Join together, there's great deals when you do that, and just have that extra support, okay? Starting a new journey is a fragile thing, okay? If you have a negative experience off the bat, you're less likely to continue. So anything to just help your journey become a better experience, will help you ultimately get to where you want to get long term. So grab yourself a partner or find somebody with that like-minded mindset with similar goals. It's also great to have that gym partner, okay? Take that extra rep. You got this. Yeah. That's James for me, okay? When I'm doing hip thrust and I'm like, okay, I'm good, he says one more rep. So makes all the difference. All right, guys, so that was it. Those were my top 10 tips for starting a healthy and fit lifestyle in 2020. Hope this has helped you in some way. Comment down below your thoughts, and always remember to just go slow and steady. There's no rush, there's no finish line, okay? Just because it's 2020, you don't just have this one year. You got the rest of your life. So hopefully these tips can help you put them to use, and with each one, just kind of slow and steady and gradual, baby, and you will be that much closer to having your healthy and fit lifestyle. All right, guys, so thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.